today we are going to see cyclic group in abstract algebra. This is a common UG syllabus. The definition for cyclic group: let G be a group and let A be any element of G. The set A equal to X belongs to G such that X equal to A power N for some N belongs to Z is called a cyclic group of generator A. Okay, here A is a generator I call, right? And I write this A with some different bracket, right? The group G is called a cyclic group if there exists an element A belongs to G such that G equal to A with the bracket. What is that bracket? This bracket specify this A is a generator of G. Okay, in here A is a generator of the group G. Okay, that means the group, every element of the group generated by that element A only, right? Okay, I want to give you an example for that, how the generator should be. Here I am taking a group with elements 1, minus 1, I, minus I. Here I is the generator. I power 1 gives you I. I power 2 gives you minus 1. I power 3 gives you minus I. I power 4 gives you 1. Here the 1 is the identity element we know in this group, right? I is the generator of G now. What about minus I? The minus I powers also gives the same element, right? So the minus I is also a generator of this group G. This group G is a cyclic group since it have a generator I and minus I. Okay, can you understand now? Yes. Now another example, here Z plus the modulo plus, okay, 12, modulo 12. Okay, 3 is the generator. So 0 plus is the operator, right? Okay, 0 plus 3, 3. 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 3, 9. Okay, here 3 is the generator, right? Here 5 is the generator. Okay, 0. 0 plus 5, 5. 5 plus 5, 10. 10 plus 5, 15. But the 12 modulo, na? So plus modulo. Okay, so 12, na, remainder is 3. Okay. Okay, next 15 plus 5, 20. 20 in a 12 modulo, so remainder is 8. So similar, we are getting like this. This is Z12. Okay, hence 5 is the generator of the group G. Okay, can you understand now? So few more example also I want to give you now. Z plus 2, 2 is the generator. Okay, 2 is the group over integers. 2 is the generator of 2z. Okay, next, Z plus is a cyclic group and the generators of that Z plus is 1 and minus 1. NZ plus is a cyclic group, under plus is a cyclic group, N and minus N are generators here, and Z 8 plus is a cyclic group, 1, 3, 5, 7 are all the generators of this group, many generators in this group, right? Okay, Z N plus is a cyclic group for all N belongs to Z. N, 1 is the generator of this group. In fact, if M belongs to Z N, M comma N equal to 1, then M is generator of this group. Okay, so now the group G with the elements 1, omega, omega square, where omega not equal to 1, is a cube root of unity. It is a cyclic group. Omega and omega square are generators of the group G. In group G, Z7 without 0 under dot, 3 and 5 are both are generators. Okay, these are the few more examples for cyclic group. Here I am giving you the generator of this group. You please try it is a group or not. Okay, everything are groups, I said, you verify it. Okay, few more examples of a cyclic group. R plus is not a cyclic group since for any x belongs to R, x is equal to nx, n belongs to z, not in R. So the property is not satisfied, therefore it is not a cyclic group. Okay. Next, q plus is not a cyclic group. And g equal to 2 power n, n belongs to z is a cyclic group. Okay. Not a cyclic group also, I gave the example to you. You please refer and verify it is a cyclic group or not. Okay. So it's for your work. Okay. Next, some properties about cyclic group. Any cyclic group is abelian, but its converse is not true. Abelian groups are not cyclic groups. Okay. Any abelian groups not cyclic group. Okay. So subgroup of a cyclic group is cyclic. Any group of prime order is cyclic. For example, order of G, 2 is a prime number, right? 3 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number. So in this order, the groups are cyclic groups. Okay. In a cyclic group, the order of a generator is equal to the order of the group. Order of A is equal to order of G. So order of G equal to P square, then G is abelian group. Then G is an abelian group. Okay. So now a proposition. Let G be a group and let A belongs to G. A, the set generator A is a subgroup of G. Definite on groups, subgroup is a cyclic group. One of it. Okay. If K is any subgroup of G such that A belongs to K, then A contained in K. Okay. The generator A contained in K. Next proposition. Let A be an element of group G if A has infinite order and A power K equal to A power M for integers K, M, then K equal to M. If A, that means in any way cyclic, no? So one powers, yeah, I power 1, I power 2, I power 3, I power 4, I power 5, etc, etc. And one, in any of the powers, it should be equal. Again, it cyclically repeats. The elements cyclically repeats. The A power K equal to A power M. Okay. When K is equal, then K equal to M. If A has a finite order and K is any integer, then A power K equal to E, if and only if order of A divides K. In some of the cases, the power of A becomes the identity. Okay. And on that case, order of A divides K. If A has a finite order of A equal to N, then for all integers K, M, we have A power K equal to A power M. If and only if K is a congruent modulo M mod n. Furthermore, the generator of A modulus gives the order of the element A. Okay. Next, corollary to Lagrange theorem. For n, already we know order of A divides order of G. It's a Lagrange's theorem. For any element in G, order of A is a divisor of modulus. For any A belongs to G, A power N equal to E, for N equal to modulus of G. Here G is the group. Okay. So any group of prime order is cyclic. Already I gave the example also. Order of G equal to 2, order of G equal to 3, order of G equal to 5 are cyclic groups. Okay. So now the proposition next. Let A be an element of group G if A has an infinite order and A power K equal to A power M, for integers K, M, then K is equal to M. If A has a finite order, K is any integer, A power K equal to E, if and only if A order of A divides order of K. Okay. So, next proposition, G equal to generator A, be a cyclic group with modulus G equal to N. If M belongs to Z, then A power M equal to A power D, where D equal to GCD of greatest common divisor of m and n, and a power m has order n divides d. The element a power k generates g if and only if gcd of k and n equal to 1. The subgroup of g are in 1-to-1 correspondence with the positive divisors of n. If m and k are divisors of n, then a power m contained in a power k if and only if k divides that m. Okay. So next definition is of exponent. Let g be a group. If g is a group, if there exists a positive integer n such that a power n equal to e, which power can make the element into an identity? For every element a in g, then the smallest such positive integer is called the exponent of g. Okay. So next lemma, let g be a group and a comma b belongs to g, be elements such that ab equal to ba. Commutative property, it satisfies na, if the order of a and b are relatively prime, then order of ab equal to order of a into order of b. Okay. So the next one, proposition, let g be a finite abelian group. The exponent of g is equal to the order of any element of g of maximal order. The group g is a cyclic if and only if its exponent is equal to its order. Exponent is equal to its order of in cyclic group. Now a question for you: define a cyclic group and give some examples for the cyclic group. Okay, thank you. See you again in the next video, and then bye.